Say, we're pregnant.
Oh my God.
Say, we're pregnant.
Seven weeks.
It's the 17th of February 2024 and we're going to have a baby!
That feels mad to say. 9 months done and dusted, and today is baby day.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of a...
Bittersweet, isn't it?
Bittersweet last minute arrival of baby boy. So we are actually going in for a C-section today. It wasn't planned. As if you watched the last vlog, we said it's not our preferred method of getting baby out, but we had a gruff scan the other day and it didn't go the way that we wanted to, did it really?
No, and when we spoke to the doctor afterwards, it was her decision basically it was her advice, wasn't it, that would be the best thing, yeah, the safest thing for us to do at this point.
We were literally in, weren't we, and within 2 minutes she was like, this baby needs to come out. The good thing is we're 39 weeks. She said if it's going to happen, it's better to happen now. We'd been experiencing reduced movements from the Monday. The scan was the Thursday. We did go in for monitoring on the Monday and baby were fine on the monitor, but then didn't seem to bounce back in the week, did it?
No.
So there were that, and then with the scan, he were on the 90th centile and he's dropped to below 50. I know there can be inaccuracies with the scan, but obviously from their perspective that's what they've got to go off, and the reduced movements, so they were like, get this baby out.
Yeah, so it's 5 to 7 in the morning.
We're about to go in.
Hopefully we've not got a long wait all day because we can't wait to see you.
I am shitting it.
Yeah.
We're more excited than obviously anyone and anything, but I've just got a bit of angst because obviously prefer not to have the section. I know it's going to be more of a calm, yeah, controlled environment. It's better than it ending up in an emergency or anything like that. It's just the unknown, innit? So we're going to, I think we go in now, we go to triage. I think they do my OBS, like your blood pressure and whatnot. And then they take us to the birthing suite.
Yeah.
And it's Holly's job today to capture as much as physically possible.
I'll do my best.
So if you've got nothing to watch and it's shit, It's not on me. I've got enough to do today.
Yeah, you have.
So it's on her. Apologies for this as well. This is it's going to get a lot worse. So
you're beautiful.
Thanks, love. So let's go have a baby.
Bye.
Darling,
hello.
I forgot to tell him the update. Not a good start. This is just us all over.
I think there was a miscommunication on the phone last night. Brie basically had this drink that she had to drink, so she rang up. We are 100% convinced the lady said, drink it at 7, come in at 7. So we just turned up at 7. Well, actually, you meant to ring at 7, and then they tell you when to
come. We always thought we did have to ring at 7, but then on the phone, she literally said, just come for 7, didn't you?
So
and you were stood there. My mum and dad were stood there. We all heard it.
She did say, just come at 7. So I...
She was lovely. I just feel like there might have been a little bit of a miscommunication. So now we're sat here, bouncing on the ball, and we're hoping we're not here for hours.
I need a coffee machine.
Where do you feel most of his kicks?
Around.
Yeah. I think I can feel his back coming down there.
Good one.
I can't get it past your heel.
Done a good job there. So it's now 11:10. Nothing's really progressed in that time. We was meant to be second in, we're now third in, but it just means that we're like back end of the afternoon. We've had my obs done again, all fine. Blood pressure a little bit high at first, that's come back down. The anaesthetist has been in and kind of explained the spinal procedure. Then the lady's been in explaining cord clamping, skin to skin, all the stuff that we want, and they're still going to try and kind of assist for her out there. But in terms of a time frame, we're just
we like, don't know. And you don't want to bother him, do you? And be like, when are we going? When are we going? But
you want to be like a really good patient, so yeah, that you get.
They can't really tell us, so we're just
chilling.
Yeah.
Hall's gonna go grab some lunch in a bit. We've been playing a bit of Uno. You've watched Netflix, haven't you? I'll have a bit of a doze, and then hopefully next time it'll be baby time.
Let me get it off this bloody tissue.
So that's the... Returns. No returns.
Yeah. No. You'll get it all, don't you?
So say we're feeding and we thought we'll like,
oh, you don't so. Like that, do you?
Oh. Should we just pop this on and then it's a bit warmer in there.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So we're on the postnatal ward now. This is little Freddie, who was born at 9:10 at night, and he's 7 pounds 13. And Rue's having a well-deserved rest. She's proper out of it, bless her. But it all went well. And Rue did really well, but she's just having a bit of a sleep. And so's little Freddie. Little squeaks. Go on, squeaker. Okay, mummy?
Yeah. Let's look at my little fella.
He's been quiet all morning.
Oh, he's lovely.
Beautiful.
You're probably just getting him at the wrong time.
Hey, come here, you've got a fish.
Hey, love, I can see all he's there.
Whoa.
Yeah, I've been on long enough.
Look at his little face.
Look, he's cute.
He's beautiful.
Oh, he's beautiful.
Look at that little jaw.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, look at him.
Isn't he beautiful? Mm. Spills your milk everywhere, or do you spit it out? But should we blame mummy for now?